Hey, what's up, guys? It's me, Kevin. Right after we arrived to Paris, after a two-hour transiting time, we took a short 1-hour flight to Florence. It was on Airbus A320, and there was like two flights in a row, so it's pretty taxing. But I like aviation, so no problem to me. And the really cool thing is that when our aircraft on A320 was taxiing, it taxied by our A380 which brought us here. So it was kind of a memorable moment to see the large scale of the A380, the very aircraft which brought us here. So we stayed quite a while in Florence, like maybe 7 days, 1 week. And then after that, we headed back to Paris to spend another week there, and then we went back to Singapore. So this recalls my visit to Florence 3 years ago. Again, I apologize if my video quality is not as good as you expect it to be, because I did not give a toss about my video quality at the time, but I will improve, and soon you'll be seeing a different video quality from me. So enjoy the video and remember to like, comment, subscribe.
Alright, I'm in my hotel now. It's called Florenzi Number 9 Hotel Bespoke. As you can see, Italy has all these weird colors which I really don't like, but it's a tradition, so you have to get used to it. And they kind of look pretty casual. This is my dad, as you might recognize now. And right now he's doing his work. Okay. Best trading system. Watch and learn the trading system or New York Post. 1000. CNBC, CBS News, Kahin likes this, and then Anthony Wong is on the web, and there's Wee Yao Tan. Oh, Wee Yao, the hiking leader.
Okay.
Now, let's explore my room. That's my father's room. So now let's go into our room. Alright. This is the living room. Okay. This is the dining table. I have my meals here. And this is our bedroom. You can see this double. Double bed is very cool. And this is the bathroom. This is used for washing our ass after we poo here. This is the toilet bowl. And this is the shower. And this is the safe wardrobe. And this is another bathroom.
Just go and do your thing!
Okay, this is the
socks and shoes!
This is the toilet.
Put the water bottles into the bag!
Pretty much the same. Okay. So, yeah. I'll see you later. Bye. Alright, this is a cypress tree. This is a cypress tree, my father. Kind of likes it because it's a Tuscan symbol, he says, and I kind of agree. It is quite amazing, and as you can see, this is Florence in the evening. I live in Singapore, so this really isn't an evening, if you like. If I live in Singapore, and this isn't an evening because this city isn't an evening for Singapore, because right now in Singapore it's about 3, and it's 8 here, and the sun is just setting. And in Singapore the sun normally sets at about 7. So yeah, this is a kind of like late place, I would say. I'll come back when we reach the Duomo. Okay. See ya. Okay, so this is dual mode, as you can see. This is, oh my gosh, the police car is coming. Alright, so as you can see, this is the Duomo. It's the largest dome in the world, upon what I've seen. The Duomo is basically just a tower with a very large dome with it, surrounded with very cool buildings. The big dome is the Duomo. And over here is the bell tower. We climbed it first because I thought it was pretty tall, but the Duomo is pretty also pretty exciting. So as I said, I thought this tower's the tower that was overshadowed by this Duomo. So this is the bell tower. I thought it was the tallest. And we just had a tour guide today. We had some of these buildings around here, and this is the baptistry around. It's a very old thing. These buildings date back to the 12th century when some people started building this magnificent thing. It took 500 years to build. But then this dome thing, they had a problem because they did not know how to build the dome. So then people were scratching their heads, and finally, after like a few years, they found a way to build it from the Romans, and then they decided to build an inner layer and then an outer layer to support it. But how is the inner layer supported? Well, it's supported using bricks. Bricks. And I'm not trying to be...
Herringbone-shaped bricks that interlock.
Yeah, interlocking bricks. I was just about to say that. Yeah, so, that's a very long name. And I'm not trying to be smart as... Like, okay, I'll tell you what I mean, okay? I'm not trying to, like, be so smart as if to make a documentary out of this, but still, it's still quite magnificent. So this is the baptistry, the most important building of its days. This is generally all there is of the Duomo. It's quite magnificent, but it's quite little. And it does frighten me a lot because this Duomo is very, very old, and the buildings also look quite weird. They look kind of strange, don't they? Yeah. So you should be scared of also. Yeah. Thanks for watching. I'll view the next clip soon, probably tomorrow. Tomorrow's your Fitzy Gallery. Thank you. Yep, so this is the bell tower from close up. As you can see, it's a very tall building. I thought it was taller than the Duomo originally, and I wanted to go up there. But it didn't seem very worth it because I couldn't see anything more magnificent. It's just the view that's really all good. So it's more worth it staying outside than going inside.
Yeah, you're right.
It's better. Huh? And it's better. Could you please get a closer? Could you get a closer picture of the dome? I want to like see. I want to like close up. I want to close up. I want to get a closer view of the Duomo. All right. We're gonna go and get a closer view of the Duomo. And this is the perfect spot. Yup, this is the Duomo. As you can see, this is the largest dome you would ever see. Maybe you'll see something bigger. As you can see, it's even bigger than the Melbourne Library Duomo. This is a pretty amazing city. It was the best city in the world once. You can see my perspective is the largest dome in the world. The bell tower looks big, taller than this Duomo thing. But as you can see, that's a complete illusion because the Duomo is much taller. Because yesterday I went up the bell tower, to the top, and then when I reached the top, I noticed that the dormo thing was still taller. That top thing was still much taller. Yeah, hello guys. Above there, hi dudes. Oh man, this blue. Oh man, this lighting thing coming down. I don't know what it is, but I like it. As you can see, it's a very cool thing. I wish I had it and I could bring it back to Singapore. See you when I have more exciting clips. One last look at the Duomo. And it's actually quite near our hotel, so we could actually get some videos of this every day, but you can just recap.
Let's go look at the sign, maybe that one tells you about us.
So yeah, see you when I find something interesting. Bye. Oh, sorry. Alright, so this is the Duomo. Last view, last look at the...
No, Kevin, it's the Campanile.
I mean the bell tower, last look at the bell
Campanile.
Tower. And this is the Campanile, my father says, and I have no idea what this is, and you're walking back to the hotel now, so... Yeah, see you on... good night. Hello, this is Florence in the day. As you can see, it looks pretty normal, but the colors are still very, very strange. And you be prepared to hear some noise here because this is a noisy construction site. At my own home in Singapore, I'm the only source of noise pollution, but now you will have the chance to hear something. You have the chance to hear an example of noise pollution not involving me, okay? Let's hope we hear something.
Stop.
Oh, sorry. Alright, let's go. My pants. Okay, so this is Florence in the day. You probably would hate to see these weird colors, but even though I'm getting used to it now. This is just a habit, okay? So, guys, please forgive me. This is just a habit. And my apologies. So this place is very rich with shops and fabric and stuff. Yeah. And this is the Duomo. See, this is the Duomo. It's a very cool... this is the Duomo. As I showed you last night. So today we're going to the Uffizi Gallery. You're walking there. So it's a bit of a hassle. The surprising thing is we haven't been taking any proper transport ever since we came here. Besides a taxi which brought us from the airport to the Firenze number 9 hotel. See you in the Uffizi Gallery. Bye. Okay, here we are at the Uffizi. This is David. This is not the real David.
That's
the Uffizi. I thought this was the Uffizi. Okay.
Town hall.
Sorry, I got the wrong one. Okay, so this is the Uffizi. It's a quite old building, but I'm expecting a lot from it. It's the best museum in Florence, definitely, or maybe the best in Italy. You're waiting for a tour guide. We'll see whether we can take any videos inside. If we can't, I'm sorry, but I'll spend a whole lot of time telling you about it later if I can't do it. So yeah, hope you're looking forward. Looking forward to it.
The actual one is much better.
Our tour guide's taking a lot of time to come, but meanwhile, let's just video the Florence in the morning. As you can see, it's really beautiful despite the weird colors.
What weird colors?
See, there's some weird colors here. The Italian tradition. But never mind.
Get your hands off the thing!
Sorry for blocking the photo. So I'll just relocate this. This is Perseus beheading Medusa. This is from Percy Jackson. The first time I heard about this was from Percy Jackson. my friend likes it. That guy's not really my friend, but yeah. So this is David. As you can see,
cafe. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Oh,
he has a boulder. Yes, quite a big boulder, but the original one inside the other museum, the Rio Museum, the Academia Museum, he has a bigger boulder because he's more tense. And the person who did it, who's called Thomas Angelo, he made
not Thomas Angelo.
Thomas Angelo, yes, he's called Thomas Angelo, right?
No, it's not.
Who is it?
No idea.
Alright, so yeah, he expressed David's emotions more tense. He expressed it more extremely, and then he David kind of got a boner. Because when you're tense, you get a boner. A boner's generally a boner. It's like, okay, imagine this. Your dick is the normal size, and then suddenly it begins growing rapidly, elongating until you see your blood vessels. This is maybe when you get tense or many, many other reasons. It could be for no reason also, like, last night I had a boner when I was sleeping for no reason, and I had no dreams. So yeah, this is called a boner. It's called a boner when your dick grows rapidly. But boners normally recover and they get back to their normal size in a matter of seconds. If you don't do anything to them, and you
chop it off.
Then there's another thing you can do. Hold it in, okay?
Oh, you
hold
can.
It between a crotch.
Hold it.
Hold it in between the
cuts. You sure? Does it work?
Yeah.
You tried it, eh? You better show your father. He doesn't know how to do it.
Alright then. Have you got a boner before?
Hey, Kevin. Not so close up.
Sorry.
You see all his pimples, you better not. And the fat paws.
And this guy is called Thor. This guy here. Who is he? This guy here.
Neptune. Like,
oh, Neptune. Thor. Not Thor. He's the god of the seas. He's the god of the seas, I think. Mama told me last night. He controls the sea. He controls tsunamis and stuff. But then not to the
limit. No, hang on, hang on. He's not. He's in the Roman god. He's called Neptune, but in Greek, he's called Poseidon. Okay.
Oh yes, the Percy Jackson. See Percy Jackson. Oh, there's a vehicle coming. Okay, so this is Perseus beheading Medusa. I don't think Medusa is mentioned in Percy Jackson. Actually, I don't even know, but yeah, so hope you have a fun time in there. Hope you appreciate Italy. And don't worry about the weird colors, you get used to them. So if you can't get used to them, you need to take pills. You need to take Italian pills. So. Yeah, never mind. Anyway, let's hope I have a good time and wish me luck. Okay, so I'm in the fancy gallery now. This is our tour guide.
Painting. On wood.
Yes, yeah.
Yes.
Okay, let's go into some of our paintings.
Plaster,
sculptures here, as you can see. This gallery is pretty amazing.
With respect,
you have to work for it. We only have about 10 minutes left.
The plaster dries.
The plaster dries.
I'll put it in rest later.
Which is...
This is the first floor of the Vitsi Gallery.
Okay. But not in the
head. We're almost done with this.
Yeah,
it was a good gallery. There's paintings, there's details, so yeah.
I feel like the Vatican were huge buyers of ancient Roman.
Oh, were they?
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. No, the collection is unbelievable. Because I know you're probably thinking of religion, because the greater the collection, the greater you are. Mm-hmm. It's absolutely a reflection of the culture. That's right.
Very cool.
Yeah, because Cosmo I does have a very smart, a bit more famous for tapestries are a collection of French.
So many rooms, man.
So Cosmo I is a very smart. He actually creates Italian's first, the first Italian tapestry manufacturer.
This is
going to be because fortune. Because Flemish artisans and teachers. system, and then you text it.
This is Nico K's baby self. He's too big to be a baby. Nico K. Do you know he weighs 84 kilograms now?
Everybody who's a duke, anybody who's aristocratic, like any rulers, any majesties, have to have a dwarf. It's a symbol of aristocratic rules.
Oh, this is the back of the gun. Oh, this is the Jesus Christ.
This one I picked.
Ask them that. Yeah, that's too slow.
That's impossible.
Yes.
This is the most important portrait of the city.
Oh.
Eleonora. Exactly.
Lorenzo.
This is about me.
The Pope.
No, that was Lorenzo Magnificent's second son. Well done.
Oh, no, no, no.
And you're surrounded by his, there's Cosmo. And this is, but this is absolutely the most famous portrait in Florentine history.
Mm-hmm.
So, Cosmo, in the aristocratic society, but he's become the Duke.
Mm-hmm.
He's got to be more Duke-like than anybody else in Europe who's grown up like that. So that's why he creates, first of all, why did he move into the town hall to make it his first ducal palace? Because you need to cut off the head of the Republic. You move to the other side of the river where you can buy a lot more land and be on the Grand Ducal Gardens. That's why would you bother converting the town hall into a palace? Because you want to do it for political reasons. Why would you marry someone from Spanish royalty? Because she's going to bring up about 300 Spanish nobles to Florence. You understand what the court is all about. If you've never had a court with the whole etiquette, you need somebody to come show you. So marrying her is perfect. And you need all the art to reflect that. Do you feel now that there's a sense of coldness and separation, distance?
Exactly.
You do not get warm and fuzzies when looking at this. She's not going to kind of look at you and smile. That's deliberate. Because she is not like you. She is your duchess, and you are her subjects. Whereas before, in portraiture in a republican period, like the Republican, devastation and emotion. This wonderful sense of, how can you tell that we're in the 1500s here? Well, overuse of emotion is wonderful. Look at bringing it, they're actually negating its anti-classical. Bronzino is no longer in the Renaissance, we call it mannerism. Mm-hmm. And it's when they actually stop using a lot of things that I've been mentioning. Like no more recession back of space, it's actually the reversal. It's bringing everything to the foreground and negating any sense of space. And, for example, negating any sense of space. Look at that. There's really no relation between the huge figures in the foreground and background. Do you feel that? There's no kind of seamless transition. And it's the same painter. Also looking here, look at the genius use of colours. Look at that fabulous, the shot silk that she's wearing as well. This is all to catch your eye for a greater effect. Mannerism is coming from the word manner, where you feel even more than ever the hand of the artist. So you can see the artificial take here of the colours, but that heightens your experience with the work. So more than ever before, you're calling this a work of art, actually.
Yep. Nice expression. It's a very good expression.
Yeah. Real pathos. We call that the real pathos.
It's got pathos. How sad they are.
Devastation.
Who is your Giovanni, Pope Leo X? Raphael was Giovanni's favourite painter. And when he became Pope Leo X, the first Medici.
It's a different Giovanni from the
different Giovanni.
Okay.
Why you have so many clients? Because Giovanni Battista joined the Baptist is the famous Baptist. That's why John is a super used name. That why they choose the word Leo as his papal name, because the lion is a symbol of Florence.
Oops.
That is open to the book of John, by the way, that book. And people would have had fun in detecting that, exactly. And now, the Republic, his grandson, he's the one who backs the Antipope. His grandson is Lorenzo the Magnificent. He is Lorenzo the Magnificent's son.
Oh, I see. Okay. So
he dies in the 1520s. Cosmo I is he comes to power in 1537. The problem is, in your mind right now, the two Cosmos, yeah.
Two seats there.
Yeah, exactly. He was a total unofficial ruler. So in fact, that's why we call 1534 is the day of the beginning of his monarchy.
Oh my gosh.
Like the way I would talk about it. 1520.
That's a Venus.
Is it? Yeah, Kevin.
Is it? No, it's not. I don't think it is.
Yeah, it's
the Venus of Urbina.
It's but.
It's Venus, the goddess of love.
Oh. Oh, okay. Okay.
Masqueraded, really as a naked, sensual woman.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, because she's shown in a normal house. So this is really risque. And we think the symbolism of a dog is fidelity.
She's no flesh! Please! Please, check your camera before shooting. Please.
That background is exactly what a house would look like. You don't hang any clothes, you put it in chests. And you've got tapestries on the wall, if you're a wealthy person. And then the rose is for purity, so it's sensual. Do you see that? Bottom left, top right. And look at the flesh. Unlike Michelangelo, who didn't blend his colours in order to create a sense of real harshness almost. Look at Titian. Look at those pink knees. Look at those white flesh and the shades of blue to white wood. And look at the golden hair. That is actually called Titian's red nowadays. You can actually buy that in an art supply store because Titian perfected golden hair. So Titian, in the 1500s, is the mecca, like the mega genius of Venetian art. Michelangelo is, I've spent most of your time in Rome, but is the Florentine genius. And there are two different art schools, and in the 1600s in France, the kings are going to...
Nice. I think you can.
think you can take video.
Yeah, okay.
I'm videoing a picture. I'm videoing mommy's picture. This is the picture my mother took. Oh, another nice painting here.
Federico Montefeltro, and his son has no ears.
Oh, okay. Oh, so, wow.
We shift
just like Vincent Van Gogh.
Of the Delaware River. And the Delaware River family is that. And they love the tissue.
Oh, I think you're looking at the end already. Kind of.
Hey, Hope 67. For one of the sister chapels of Delaware. Julius II, one of the commission of the
Oh, nice museum.
And then lastly,
he's looking through a hole. So he couldn't shoot.
This is from the head of Medusa.
It's a head with snakes. Yes. It's a head with snakes. It's snakes kind of like her hair. And Caravaggio.
I'm going to go to a restaurant now. So, it was a nice tour and see what you have to do. We may go back to the door tonight. So, yeah, see you. Bye. This is the Annunciation. This is the Annunciation. I think. Bye. Okay, this is Duomo in the day. I don't think I can see very clearly, but. Yeah, this is Duomo in the day. It looks less scary than it does at night. And this, I haven't been videoing for 2 days, and I'm very sorry because, we had to be in a bit of a rush because of this guy. So today we're going to Pitti Palace. I don't know whether we can take any videos there, but if we can take videos, that's good. If not, then I'll tell you about it later. It's the place where the Medici's live. They're generally the best people.
Tessuti, yeah.
Tessuti means fabric.
They're generally the best. The best artist family in the world at the time. They became extinct in the 1700s, the Medici's. They became extinct in the 1700s. This family has been replaced by what? What's the greatest family?
Now? I think it was a republic. It became a republic. So.
Alright, a republic. Some republic. Guild. Oh yeah, guild. Kind of. Okay, I'm really confused, okay, but this is what I know. Uffizi means office. So then there was some guy in there who controlled all the guilds. The guilds who worked in there. And then they had restricted power, so. Oh, there's a dog. Is it the dog? Oh, yeah, so. Yeah, see you in the Pitti Palace, so. Bye. Okay, so this is Pitti Palace. It's rather nice. Pretty much better than I expected. I thought it was just kind of a stopgap here. For the Uffizi, but then it's actually quite a magnificent marvel.
Huh?
Let's hope this tour will be worth it. I don't know what type of museum it is. So yeah. See you when you're inside the museum. Bye.
I want to show you my expertise. Oh no, he's scaring away already. Ah, you stole my thunder, boy. I hate you. Okay, I can scare these birds away now. See? Noise energy. Noise energy wins. Alright. Some statue here. Bartolomeo Amanetti.
Put it in your pocket, how about that?
The main thing is inside. Oh, okay. It's just a temporary accident.
The main thing is the flight.
Cosimo number one. Let's see Cosimo first. I saw this a few days ago.
Oh yeah, this is a Thor. Thor.
Huh? Where do we see this face? Remember?
Outside the David.
Yes.
The David.
Yeah, that's right. Where was he?
Neptune.
It's right, that's right. Yes.
This is Neptune.
Cosimo first is that? No, the
Neptune.
The yeah. So he's saying he's hit himself as Neptune.
He beheaded himself.
Huh?
He beheaded himself. I'm recording right now. Daddy, I'm recording. Neptune?
Mm-hmm. Well, no, they had a plague, so a lot of people died, so...
Oh, okay.
So he...
How come neither
prayer? Yeah, that's right. It's a big part of the history.
That's what happens if you keep pulling at yourself, it drops off, see?
He's got too many... Yeah, let's see, what has... See, he's got too many bonus, so then his blood vessel burst, and then his... And after that, his penis dropped off. And this is a woman, so she has no penis, as you can see.
Shut up!
Hey, look, this guy has no penis.
Go on, yeah, somebody cut it off, yeah?
He's got too many bonus.
Must. Huh?
He got too many bonus.
Too many? None.
No, if you have too many bonus, your penis cannot stop the stress.
Roman. Yeah, it's just...
Too much light. Can't see.
The model is Versailles, yeah? So this is a mini Versailles. Gardens and palace. You know, interesting thing is he is actually not a royalty, but he's got a crown. They're trying to become a royal family.
Neptune.
He wants to be seen as a royal.
Neptune.
It's a miniature version of Versailles. Beautiful garden set.
Is this a secret after, garden?
Yeah, after we finish the... It's a bit like that. We come here after the... finish the garden.
I know. Where's your set here?
If we look at that.
I mean, look. This guy's been missing a mess.
What happens when you're not
seeing? Oh, this one's still
there. Okay, Donald and Chuck coming.
Let me zoom in.
Not here.
Oops, too much light. There's too much contrast.
Mm-hmm.
The room was great.
The sister of Napoleon is there here.
I know, this is the Grand Duchess thing.
too. Something about the mystery of war or some such thing. But I could find it online again. It's seemingly a very beautiful friend in Italian. Just about Giovanni Dalli Bandinelli, this mythic figure. Now this is, and clearly again, interior design. Because remember, you're in Rome. So this and this are just constructed.
Okay. It's a Madonna in charge.
Yeah, this one.
This
Madonna. Which one? The circle one. The circle one.
Uh-huh.
The one below the this,
the
top.
Huh?
It's Domenico.
Just the one. Same one,
Cap. None of them are the same. None of them.
It's a circle one. Remember circle?
Circle is crazy.
Yesterday, what day before, what did Freya tell you?
Circle means Holy Spirit.
It's a picture of the Holy
Spirit. What's the difference between this Madonna and Cup?
I don't know. Okay, this is the real Madonna and Child.
Look at the colors of the Madonna. Okay.
Look at the colors of mommy's hair. Oh yeah, they're not golden. They are not in heaven.
What's he doing? He's eating something, right? What's he eating?
He is eating himself.
Pomegranate.
Oh, wow.
To new Chinese. This first circular word.
Madonna
and eating a pomegranate.
Excuse me. One of the reasons I have pomegranates in my paintings. But of course, look at the background where he's divided up the steps. Mm-hmm. So he can include a variety of different scenes. So when you sort of the top right on the stairwell, you have Mary's parents, Joachim and Anne. And Joachim has actually, he's just
very
much like that. And
in his ear,
remember he leaves
what he's going to have to do.
And in his ear, was
the side
from the three
graces. Happy baby here.
And of course, remember I described that process of the...
So Kevin, remember what the circular frame means?
It means
the
process to do all of this gilding. The frame maker that I work with, I can show you one of the frames.
Oh,
one of the individual who's 77 Louis Vuitton. Same process. If there was a chunk of this missing, he has
Florence,
to start at the beginning, preparing, and
exactly birth,
the same
birth of a child.
Birth
of a child.
Someone
right?
Used flesh.
Huh?
It's a very, very intensive. And it's good to have this planned out. Well, I think they've done that so that.
I think this is 3D painting. You see the
faces
on the right.
Bigger
looks like 3D, right?
I think that's kind of just like it.
Okay,
come
next one.
This is Napoleon's bathroom.
Shishi?
He never came down. Look at him. Look at Daddy.
Roman
Look at his eyes. Right? Sparkling eyes.
Kevin, don't do that. It's too close. It's horrible.
See?
Columns.
Many paintings of Jesus nowadays, but this one's very chubby. This painting I've seen.
The theme is circles.
This is Mother Mary, Virgin Mary, and this is Jesus.
See the semicircle back, the semicircle
and this
here.
Is John the Baptist.
Two circles symbolizing how close they are together.
Huh? What?
There are two circles here, one circle here. Semicircle here to show.
I don't see any two circles. Are they faint?
Here, can we watch?
Faint ones.
Here. And here is symbolic circle, it's not a
I can't
cross
see them,
circle.
You're imagining things.
The curve, look at the curve, Kevin, the arms follow the curve, it's a semicircle.
Oh my gosh, I can't, you're imagining things.
Kevin, two semicircles.
Mommy. Alright, my mother's here to clarify this.
Huh? Your mama cannot see the semicircle.
Suppose there's a circle. I can't see a thing, because
two semicircles.
Yeah. Alright, I'll show you on my video. Look at my video.
Semicircles to show their how close they are.
See? Daddy, don't imagine things. Stop imagining things.
Cannot see the circle?
Stop imagining things.
Huh? Semicircles.
Don't imagine. Yeah, you say so.
What? It's symbolism, Kevin. It's a simple symbolize.
But none of us can see it. It's like my mother can't even see it.
It's part of the composition. It's a trick of the to show you how close they are.
It's an imagination.
Kevin, this one here, see? Oh, semicircle and then one semicircle here.
What the? Alright, let's see what. I can't see any of them. You can say so lah. You can say so. I agree that. Yeah, steady. I agree that you agree that there's a circle.
Semicircle.
It's a semicircle. This guy looks at you very intently. In fact, you see everything he can about you. And that is why people hate him so much.
Hell.
Quite cool at this thing.
This is how the cupboards look like. This is how your cupboard looks like. Ding, ding. Imagine your own cabinet at home. Yeah, really? Those are refined details.
From 1677.
It's called Mother of Pearl. Do you know Mother of Pearl?
No. Mother of Pearl means the mother of Mary who carries a pearl. Okay, there's some kind of guy coming towards us. Yeah, so this is the building. It used to be some butcher stores here, but then all these buildings used to be lined up on this bridge, but then they wanted to connect another side of it to this one, so then they built some walkway here, which is how the bridge came about, and there was a bit of overlaps here, so then they helped some little sales to bring these buildings in. But then people around thought, you know, this was too noisy, so they changed. So they changed the butcher stores to the jewelry stores. I mean smelly, okay, they were too smelly, so then, yeah, they were changed to the jewelry store, so, yeah, here we are. That's generally all the knowledge I have of this area.
Kyoto
besides,
Tower, that's the Kyoto
besides
Tower.
Besides that Kyoto Tower there.
Kyoto
Tower. So, yeah, we should be heading back to the apartment soon, and bye. Okay. Bye. Okay, this is the underground of the Duomo. It is said that a church was built here before, at the same place where the Duomo is right now, before the Duomo, in 500 AD.
Roman.
It's a Roman, yes. But then, nobody knows what happened.
Why are you shooting the ground?
nobody knows what happened to it, but then the Duomo kind of was built over this church, and yeah, so this is underground, the remains of this kind of church, and actually we can see the inside of the Duomo once you get back up, so I'm going to show you the exclusive view of inside the Duomo, so yeah, hope you enjoy it. Quite magnificent view of the remains of the church. So yeah, see you when you have a view of the inside the church. See ya, bye. Alright, this is the inside of the Duomo. As you can see, pretty amazing. Even though it looks quite bare, you can see the outside is very awesome. And that's the top of it. Oh yes, and we're going to be going up the Duomo later, so yeah, we'll view even more there. Thank you. Okay, this is the baptistry, very near the Duomo. As you can see, it's a very, very nice church. Used to be the most important building in Florence, but it's now replaced by scaffolding and stuff because it's the Pope is coming, so it needs to be refitted. So yeah, this is a very sad moment. Anyway, my camera's running out of memory, so I can only record for like 8 more minutes. Yeah, 8 more minutes exactly. So yeah. I'll record the Duomo and I'm gonna record the Duomo soon, so yeah, see you, bye. Alright, I'm in Florence Airport now. It was really sad. I left. Well, the hotel was a very nice hotel, and I really appreciate Florence the way these Italians live, and I especially like the Duomo, as I told you on the first day, because well, if you put yourself into people's shoes, you'll know how much effort they took to build it. So thank you. So yeah, see you when I'm in Paris, or maybe in the middle of the flight, or maybe in this airport. Thank you.
Alright guys, that's gonna wrap it up for this video. Thank you so much for watching this video, I really appreciate all these views. And as you know, I'm just a starting YouTuber, I've got very few subscribers right now. So my video recording skills might not be as good as you expect. I've been known to be very shaky in my videos and stuff, but rest assured, as we go along, I will improve based on feedback from my subscribers and most of my viewers. And I will not be posting very frequently because I'm really caught up with work and stuff. But if you really, really want to see more of this awesome quality content, remember to leave a like, comment down below, and subscribe to my channel. And also remember to check out my other videos. I mostly do aviation things, so for those aviation enthusiasts, you might want to check out my channel as well. And again, remember to like, comment, and subscribe, and thank you so much for watching my videos. Peace.